When you take a look at the Southside team, I know you're only 3 days into practice, but what have you liked from this team, and what has the offseason been like leading up to this year?
Really intense, and we all bond together really well, so it's a good group of guys.
I know that you didn't get as many W's as you would have liked last season, so what do you learn from that experience?
That you can't take anything for granted, and you got to play it play by play, listen to the coach's game plan, and execute.
Let's start on the defensive side of the football. Who are some of the guys that are going to be playing bigger roles for Southside here in 2019, and what are going to be some of the strengths of this defense?
Manny Knight, our number one, he's going to be a big part of it, clogging up the middle. And then Dylan Jackson, he plays safety. He's really good. And then me and Maxwell got the outside locked up.
Defensively, what has been the point of emphasis in camp so far?
Just do what you're told. Like, follow the game plan to a T, and it'll work.
Tell me about this offense. What do you look like on the offensive line, and who are going to be some of the players on the offense overall that are going to be playing bigger roles?
Okay, one of our big offensive guys is kind of underrated because he's shorter, but Devontae Alford, yeah, he's going to be our X factor this year.
What position does he play?
He's our X receiver, yeah.
And then kind of what has been the focal point of offense this coming year? Obviously, you know, Omar Jackson was kind of a do-it-all guy for you, and you graduated some other talented guys. So what's the focus leading up to getting this offense on the same page?
Again, just following the game plan. We got to get our offensive line to get down to blocking, just block through the whistle. And then everything else, just execution.
All right. Final question, what are you most looking forward to?
Most looking forward to game one, play one. Just executing.
All right. Perfect, my man. So obviously this team has had 3 days to get things going, but you've been together throughout the offseason. So leading up to the opener on August 23rd, what do you like about this Southside football squad?
It's like we got our brotherhood. We built a bond together, unlike last year. Not everybody was really close, but this year it's like we're super close with each other, and we know each other like inside out.
Last season, obviously, you know, 0-10 is not what you wanted. How do you go about getting more W's, and what do you learn from last year that you can apply?
It's just keep fighting because it's not going to be easy. But we're just taking one game at a time and one drive at a time, basically it.
All right. Tell me about this offense. What stands out to you about the offense, and who are some guys that are going to be taking bigger roles as we enter 2019?
We all going to contribute, but some guys is Deontray coach, Dylan Jackson, Javarius Jones, and Devontae Alford.
And what excites you about this offense? What do you think are going to be the strengths?
Pretty much everybody. If everybody do their job, we're going to move the ball down the field and win games.
As the quarterback, you're in charge of the offense. What do you kind of tell some of these guys? What are you trying to do to coach up some of the young guys that are going to be playing more snaps this year?
Just buy in and just be ready for your time.
Did you start every game last year?
No, sir.
You start about half the season?
Yes.
Who was Omar starting certain times, or how did you guys play? What was the quarterback dynamic like last year?
It was like Omar really went in most of the time, but it was just like one game was just my time to go in, and then I just did what I had to do.
Perfect, man. And you pronounce it Demere, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, gotcha. So, Southside, you guys have had 3 days of practice. This is day three, but you've been together throughout the offseason. So, what do you like about this team? What are going to be some of the strengths as we enter the new year?
I like a lot of stuff about this team. It's like we picked up some of the younger guys from last year, picked them up. They starting to step up and stuff like that, and everybody's like starting to prove.
Tell me about this defense. Who are some of the guys, names-wise, that are going to be stepping into bigger roles, and what are going to be some of the strengths of this team on the defensive side?
Devontae Williams, he's going to be a junior this year. Javonte Malone, they're going to be real good. Devontae didn't start last year, but he's going to play a big role on off defense.
Is there a position group or a position that you think is going to be really counted on to lead this defense?
Yeah, linebackers especially, because we lost Taj Alford, senior last year, so we got to step up.
When you take a look at this team offensively, what do you like?
I like the run game. The run game is going to improve this year. Got linemen, returning alignment from last year, and we got senior running backs.
Obviously, last year 0-10, that is not the record that you wanted to have. What do you learn from that experience, though, that makes you hungry to start off and get things rolling here on August 23rd?
Coming in, we're going to be underdogs. Everybody's going to be like thinking that they're going to beat us automatically. So we just got to take it game by game and just improve our practice.
Final question: what are you most looking forward to about 2019?
2019, I'm looking forward to just balling out with my brothers.
All right. Perfect, man. What is it that you like about the Southside team as the season rolls around?
I see big improvement. we came in with a notion coming from the summer to start preseason, you know, in-season practice on a high note. And that first 2 days, that's what we did. Right now, we're just building and building, and I like the effort that we're giving. And I see a lot of improvement.
Defensive side of the football, who are some of the guys that are going to be taking bigger roles for Southside here, and what are some of the big strengths for you guys defensively?
Well, we got Emmanuel Knight, who's going to play the linebacker spot, and he's going to be he's a senior. He's our leader. He's going to be that captain of that defense. He's actually going to go both ways. But Deontray, coach, is also a defensive guy that's going to lead us on the way. Claudill, and he's another senior out of those three that's going to lead us. Dylan Jackson is going to play the safety spot. And we got more of a veteran group coming back on that defense, and our defense should be the strongest point.
Offensively, what are some of the strengths? And, again, who are some of the guys that are going to be playing bigger roles as you enter 2019?
Well, first of all, you got Demere Clark that's starting at the quarterback spot, and he's got two guys behind him that's pushing him. But he has some experience last year. He should be ready to go, and he's going to be our front runner starting out.
Having a quarterback that I believe he started about half the games last year for you, that's always something nice for a head coach to have a quarterback with experience. How do you build off that and put up some more offensive numbers as opposed to last season?
Well, we changed the offense up. I think this offense is more suitable for what we have personnel-wise. Biggest thing is our line, first and foremost. We got the seven linemen within that varsity scheme that's really competing for those five positions on line. And then we got some other backups that are linemen quality players that's willing to learn and go in there and get their, you know, put their hand in the dirt and, you know, grind it out for us. And it starts, the offense starts with that. If you ain't got an offensive line, you ain't got nothing. I don't care what kind of skill players you have.
What are you changing schematically from what to what?
Well, the last year and the years beforehand, you saw we threw a lot, and we were more like 60-40, throw the ball. We're going to switch that up around, you know, and make sure that, you know, we can try to establish our run game first and then, you know, open up some passing. So you'll see a different offensive unit out there. And so like I said, we average 20 yards rushing, which is that's one of our downfalls. And, you know, our offense put the defense in particular situations that you would never want to be in. And we're going to try not to do that this year and make sure that we, you know, expect to put some points up on the board and expect to get first downs and expect to drive that ball.
Obviously, it wasn't the record that you wanted last season, but what did these guys learn from that experience, and how does that kind of fuel them to have a better season, especially the seniors who will be playing their last football?
No one wants to go 0-10, but the learning aspect of going 0-10, these seniors know why they went 0-10. You can talk all about schematics. You can talk about, you know, what was what, but these seniors know that, hey, we didn't do what we're supposed to. We didn't have the off season we needed to have. We didn't have the kind of character we needed to have. We didn't have people staying out of trouble that needed to be on the field. And we didn't drive our guys in pass block the way we needed to do. And they know that was a big reason why we went 0-10. So they've been preaching and talking to the younger guys and saying, hey, 0-10, that's not going to happen again. Let's make sure we work. Let's make sure we do what we have to do. And they've caught on and take heed to the words that the coaches have been, you know, saying to them. And they actually been pushing the group. And it's like I said, this senior, I told the seniors, we're going to go as far as y'all take us, leadership-wise.
Perfect. Anything else you'd like to add, Coach?
Good luck to all the other teams in the SAC.